UFC Fight Night on ESPN Covington versus Lawler took place Saturday, August 3rd from Prudential Center in Newark, New Jersey. In tonight's main event, we have the very polarizing former intern title holder and number 2 ranked welterweight, Kobe Covington, taking on the former champion and number 11th ranked Robbie Lawler. Covington is now 15-1 and on an impressive 7-fight winning streak, but had not fought in over a year and was looking to extend his current win streak by taking out his second former UFC champion in a row and prove to the world he deserves a title shot opportunity. Covington brings an intense pace that most of his opponents don't have the answer for, and tonight was no different. In Covington's last fight, he won a 5-round unanimous decision over Rafael Dos Anjos to win the interim UFC welterweight title, but was later stripped due to injuries. Covington is a gritty, strong wrestler that uses forward pressure, mixing up his striking well to set up his takedowns with great level changes, and possesses incredible endurance with strong tenacity. But staring at him on the other side of the octagon, he was facing a former training partner and one of the toughest champions to ever step in the octagon in Lawler. Lawler brings a wealth of experience along with one-punch knockout power and looking to bounce back from a very controversial loss to Ben Askren in his last outing. And here's how it went down. The fight started with no touch of gloves, but to no one's surprise, there was no love lost, which is usually the case with Covington's opponents. At the beginning of the fight, Covington came out with immediate pressure and both fighters swinging for the fences early in a crazy fast pace for a 5-round fight. Covington's pressure was overwhelming and he continued to grind on Lawler, looking for takedowns throughout the fight, but he could never keep Lawler on his back with his excellent veteran defense, always getting back to his feet. The pace was crazy and this was the exact strategy Covington was looking for, wearing down the dangerous striker. Covington used his punches to set up his takedowns, followed by excellent chain wrestling throughout the entire fight, making Lawler carry his weight and wearing him down. Lawler had a few moments in the fight, landing some of his dangerous punches, but Covington was able to recover quickly and keep the heavy pressure on Lawler and stay out of trouble. Covington's most impressive attribute tonight was his cardio that allowed him to throw an insane amount of punches, but he fought an intelligent technical fight with distance control and followed his game plan perfectly to victory. Kobe Covington with the unanimous victory. Here's my final thoughts. Covington is the ultimate bad guy that you love to hate and cheer against, but say what you want about Covington, he has figured out a way to weaponize his cardio and fought a smart strategic fight using his striking to set up his chain wrestling against a very dangerous Lawler to secure a unanimous victory. His intense in-your-face pressure and incredible cardio mixing up his kicks, punches, and takedowns kept Lawler off balance and he was able to secure the unanimous victory. Guys, here's some quick stats on Covington. Covington is now 15-1 and on a 7-fight win streak. Tonight, Covington threw an incredible high volume of striking. Covington attempted 510 significant strikes. That output earned him the new UFC record for significant strikes attempted in a single fight. 246 strikes landed, 10 takedowns. He's the number 2 ranked UFC welterweight contender. He is the former UFC interim welterweight champion. He is now on a 7-fight win streak. He now holds wins over Robbie Lawler, Rafael Dos Anjos, Damian Maia, and many more. What's next for Covington? Well, there's a lot of drama in the stacked welterweight division, but the UFC president, Dana White, came out and said if Covington wins this fight, he was guaranteed a title shot against the current champ, Kamaru Usman. And on the ESPN post-fight show, Covington and Usman traded words and almost had to be separated in a very heated exchange. To me, there's only one fight that makes sense, and that's Covington versus Usman for the undisputed title. Love him or hate him, Covington showed with his last performances and another dominating victory tonight that he deserves the next shot against Usman. The UFC won't have to work very hard marketing this fight. The storyline has already been written because of their hatred for one another and their much-touted altercations in the past. I can't wait for this matchup. My fellow fight fans, don't forget to hit that like button. This is Jake Hatton with MMA Weekly's The Lowdown Breakdown. See you next time.